คมา
เดี๋ยวเราจะฝึกสปีกิ้งกันมาสปีกิ้งนะก็ประเด็นเลย fluency what is fluency speak flow ไหมไม่ต้องเร็ว normal speed นะครับ clear pronunciation speak with confidence ก็คือพูดยิ้มแย้มนะครับผม eye contact body language ไม่ต้อง tense ปุ๊บแม่งฟรีซับทุกอย่างเลย
แล้วถ้าสมมติว่าเขาถามคำถามผมมาแล้วผมไม่รู้จะตอบอะไร
pause well that's quite interesting หรือว่าเราจะบอกว่าไม่ติดใจก่อนเลยไม่รู้ฟอน imagine first part มันจะไม่มีคำถามอะไรหรอกที่เราแบบตอบไม่ได้ they gonna ask you like regular things คนส่วนใหญ่มีคำถามพาร์ทตัวเองโอเค
one minute นะ
two minute โอ้พาร์ทตัวเองหลังจาก speaking for 2 minutes เนี่ยแหละโอเคแล้วพาร์ทเนี่ยนะครับผมพาร์ท1เป็นพาร์ทที่มังกรคุณต้องใช้เรียกว่าอุ่นเครื่องเพราะว่าไงใช่ไหมไม่ต้องพูดเยอะพูดพอดีแต่ว่าตอบพูดออกมาให้มันแบบว่าเริ่มฟลอว์เหมือนกับที่เราอยู่ต่างประเทศอะไรได้แล้วพูดให้เหมือนในจริงพูด Imagine part 1 is you get to meet new friend get to know one another แล้ว part 2 เรา imagine อย่างนี้เหมือนที่เราเคยเจอเพื่อนที่อเมริกาหรือเพื่อนที่อยู่อเมริกามาแบบว่า we get to know one another we brought up a topic and you need to tell me about that topic for 2 minutesมันมีอยู่แล้วฝรั่งมันถามโอ้ใช่ไหมใช่ไหมครับ How's Thailand ใช่ไหมใช่ป่ะ Do you ride an elephant to school like yeah sort of like okay หรือว่าแบบ okay how can you tell me something about spicy food or like how's Thailand's like or I never been to Thailand can you tell me how it's like เข้าใจป่ะ That's gonna take like 2 minutes for you to tell themFor example, do you ride a freaking elephant to Thailand? I mean, to school in Thailand?
The about how what's Thailand like? มันต้องบอกไม่ต้องพูด
ถึงเนี่ยเราจะตอบใช่ไหมล่ะ Of course not. It's not like in Texas you still ride horses, you know, with cops on them. Yeah, and then explain, no, in Thailand we have vehicles and so forth.
And that vehicle being elephants.
not horses. But so then.Yeah, it's like get to know that person, นะครับ and third net is when it's kind of like a job interview, like school interview. Okay, they're gonna ask you on certain topic and idea, and you need to deliver. คือต้องพูดให้ครบตอบให้ถูกประเด็นแล้วก็ให้ example แล้วก็ให้ conclusion of idea. ตอบประมาณไม่เกินนาทีและ key part 3เนี่ย you have to use the right kind of vocabulary ที่เขาเรียกว่า lexical resources ที่มัน accurate possibleโอเคเดี๋ยวพี่จะรันดาวเราโอเคแล้วก็แต่ตรงนี้ที่ให้เนี่ยมันจะเป็นคำถามที่ค่อนข้างยากกว่าธรรมดานิดนึงเพราะว่าจะต้องทดสอบเท่าไหร่นะครับทดสอบ
ที่ ability
เยอะหรือโอเคอย่างแรกเลยเขาเข้ามาใช่ไหมเขาก็จะให้มังกรนั่งแล้วเขาก็แนะนำตัวเองแล้วบ้าเดี๋ยวเขาจะถามมังกรว่าแนะนำตัวเองแล้วมังกรก็ให้ identification เขาโอเค
identification ครับพ่อ
ใส่ yeah passportNational ID ครับมาพร้อมยังโอเค Good afternoon
Good afternoon
Yes and how are you doing today
I'm doing pretty fine actually
Okay great and can you please tell me your full name
My name is Nakhagit Ratanakanto
Excellent and what can I call you please
You can address me as Mangdon
All right Mangdon it's a pleasure to meet you My name is Kirk I will be your examiner for todayOkay,
you too.
Excellent. May I see your identification, please?
Here.
Okay, that's a very nice small passport here. All right. Okay. This is Kirk Batumanan. I will be interviewing Mangdon at the Regis Council. The date is November the 30th, and the time is 2:30. All right.Let's begin. So, do you have a large family or a small family?
My family, I have a pretty small family actually. It's not that big. It consists of roughly 7 people.
Okay. Alright. Can you tell me something about them?
Well, the thing about my family is we're not that connected at all.
Okay.
Each other live in their own areas andSo we only come together in special occasions. We just keep in contact.
Excellent. All right. So how much time do you manage to spend with the members of your family?
I usually spend my time with my family after school,
okay.
But not as much because I have to do schoolwork and other things too. But the time that I get to spend with my family really is usually Saturday and Sunday.
All right. And what sort of things do you like to do together?
Well, we like to go out for dinner,
okay,
sometimes lunch as well. We rarely do anything else.
Okay, great. So, do you get well with your family?
Well, yes, I do, but not as much as I did before.
Okay.
Because I'm a teenager.
Alright, that's understandable. Excellent. Alright, let's talk about your neighborhood a little bit here.
Okay.
What part of town do you live?
I live in the outside corner of Bangkok, which is relatively kind of underdeveloped compared to Bangkok.
Okay. So what is it like?
So my neighborhood consists of, it's pretty diverse. So once, if you look to the right, you probably see a really rich and luxurious house.
Okay.
And the other side would be probably like slums.
Okay. Okay. So what kinds of shops are there in your neighborhood?
Well, it consists of four 7-Elevens.
Okay.
And some of the small shops and food.
Okay.
Just typically those kind of stuff.
Alright. And do you get along well with your neighbors?
I don't know any neighbors.
Okay.
Well, my family do know though.
Okay.
But I don't really mind them.
Okay. And what difficulties about living there?
The difficulties living there is you have to face with the diversity. Sometimes I have insecurities about my safety. Because every time I ride my bicycle there, out there, I have to worry about the people who are slums.
Okay. Alright. Excellent. Nhiêm con đi mà làm mình confident, làm mình speaking, nè ha. Thì đi, mình accent thì đi. Yeah, you never push out too hard. Mình ha, làm mà push out too. Don't just like, oh, this slum, that.
Oh.
Breathe. When you speak, you have to breathe in and out to make sure
you don't naturally
enunciate. No. Naturality comes with enunciation. For example, like when we have a brain freeze, when we're thinking about slum or whatever, try fill it in the what? Well, if there's any difficulty that I can imagine, it's probably the safety of my personal well-being. Because, you know, when I ride my bicycle around, you know, dusk or dawn for that matter, I mean, I like to exercise. Sometimes I'm a little bit worried about the neighborhood because it comprises of slum. And those people sometimes, I'm not quite sure they're immigrants or they are, you know, my neighbors or not. So sometimes I'm a little bit worried.
You feel well, you're not tired.
In natural speech, you know how white people talk. Okay, they pause, they go up, they go down, you know, you feel relaxed. You don't have to push it out, okay? Because the more you push it out, the more you feel like pause. That was sometimes, if you make a mistake for a minute, like, oh, I meant to say, well, excuse me, I was going to say, oh, by the way, fill it in. Don't use things, don't use stuff. You gotta have the right vocabulary. Like if you wanna use things or stuff, think of nouns that it's related to the topic. Like for example, if I don't have any ideas about things that I like to do with my parents, we can go around like this, we go what? Quite frankly, because of my hectic schedule at school, and right now I'm preparing for IELTS, I don't have a lot of time to spend with my parents. We do converse in the morning, we do catch up with each other on the messenger, but I would say I only have about a few hours per week, you know, to go out and have a proper dinner with them. Because my father is a very busy businessman too.
Hmm. Oh, shit.
Not hard. Don't push too hard when you speak, okay? So now we're gonna recorrect on the hard one, okay? We're gonna recorrect in a way that, here, I'll show you on part one. I picked family and neighborhood for you already. You may pick whatever you want.
Okay. ask you.
Yes, I will.
Oh, that,
yeah.
You can ask me anything. And then I'll show you the proper way of doing it. Don't make that little.
Yeah, I'm not looking, just ask.
But accommodation and
everything. Yeah, just speak clearly so I understand what you're telling me. Okay, come on.
Okay, accommodation and education.
Okay, you don't have to tell me a topic. Dude, just like, okay, I would like to talk about accommodation now, and then just like, okay, ask me the question, come on.
Oh, you want me to ask you?
Yeah, so I can tell you the right way you speak,
okay.
Speak in the confidence.
So now, I would like to ask you about your accommodation.
Alright.
So, what kind of accommodation do you live in? What's it like?
Well, I do own a house now. It's a two-story house in the same village where I work at the moment. I do own Quest here, and then you just need to walk down to Soy, and I have a nice little two-story house with a lawn. And to be honest, the house used to belong to my aunt, and she sold it to me because she wanted to retire up north in the country.
I see.
So the house is a bit old, but I repaired it. I'm sorry. So frankly, right now the infrastructure is a lot better now.
I see.
Yeah.
So. Have you always lived there?
Well, actually, I used to live there for about 10 years. And then when I turned 13 years old, I moved to America. So I didn't live there for about almost 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
So when I came back to the house, the frame of the house was quite ran down a bit. So it took me almost 2 years to fix it to the condition that was habitable. Yeah.
So, what change would you like to make to improve it?
Well, certainly, I would like to have a larger garage because we have three cars now, and one of them is a truck. So it's quite sizable, and it's actually quite cumbersome when you try to back up the truck into the garage. So I definitely would like to do some home improvement on the front of the house, which is a bigger garage.
So, would it be easier for you to move to another accommodation?
No, I like the house. It has a certain sentimental value to me. So, I'm very fixated to actually live and possibly raise two of my children there until they graduate from college, and probably would pass on the house to my children. So, no, I would not move.
So, do many people in your country live in such accommodation?
Well, with the modern lifestyle, I would say less than half of people can afford a home. So, especially with the urban sprawl within the inner city, I believe the majority of the young urban type people would like to live on a high-rise condo. But to me, I'm in the older demographic, so owning a house is more secure in my sense.
So. What's your job?
What's my job? Well, I have several jobs actually, but if you want to consider my day job, I would say I'm a teacher. You know, I help secondary level students to achieve their IELTS and their SAT, so that would be my day job. But I do have other side projects, I mean, the financial projects and IT, I run those companies, but it's in the back burners now because I'm trying to help my wife getting this thing into a sustainable business. So I'm concentrating on the education now. So I would say I'm a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So is it a common job in your country?
Well, I would say it is one of the most general jobs anyone can get because, frankly, we probably got more teachers than soldiers in Thailand, in my opinion. And with the way of the educational frameworks are going in Thailand, I think that we definitely gonna need more teachers. So I would say teaching profession is quite common here.
So what are your working hours like?
Every day, nonstop. No, actually, I work about 12 hours a day. My day starts around 10 a.m. and then I would have to teach both online and offline, and then run the operation of my language as a school until 10, and then I have to wrap everything up, write a report for my staff, So I usually get done around midnight.
Shit.
And then, yeah, and then I, you know, have some time to finish up dinner, play with my kids, and get to bed around
midnight.
Yeah.
You're geeking. So it's
well, if you wanna run a business, you know, it takes a lot of effort.
When your kids is awake at midnight.
Yeah. When I get home, you know, they'll wait for me a bit. I mean, they're still young, you know, they're in that age and they don't still don't have to go to school yet, so they can stay up late. It's okay with them. Yeah.
Do you get a lot of vacation and off time?
I used to. Back in the days when I used to work as a financial analyst, yeah, I would take off about a month in a year to travel to the United States or going up north to visit my dad in Chiang Rai.
Mm.
But frankly, because of I have started my business for the past 3 years, it becomes quite difficult to take some time off. So if I have any kind of free vacation time, I would definitely spend it with my children. So vacation at home.
Mm. Are you thinking of changing your job?
Probably not, because I'm almost 40 years old. I need to grow my roots, and I need to have what they call soul searching. And I believe that teaching is one of the destinations that I'm looking for, helping children. So I'm very content with where I'm at professionally.
I see.
For now. Yeah. แต่มันตอนที่พูดถ้าพูดผิดก็แก้ตัวเองได้ที่พี่พูด renovate กับแม่งแบบนึกภาพว่านอนไม่พอบลาบลาบลาคือนอนประมาณ5ชั่วโมงแต่ว่าWhen you clear yourself, correct yourself, look the accent, the mouth, keep good, naturally. Just feel natural to speak. Don't think that instructor, they hear you hurt your score. No, they hear to help you. And the way they answer, just comfortable, use good words. Focus. Me learn, me focus the crucial job. Yeah, that 8.0 and more, okay? Okay. But of course, the thing that's gonna hurt you, things and stuff and all other things. Yeah,
specific.
Yeah, just lexical resources, very important, okay? Now we're gonna move on to part two. Part two, I will tell you in English, okay? On part two, you will be given a card with a list of topics, okay? And then when I inform you that you can turn over the card, you will have 1 minute to make any notes on it. And then that when 1 minute is up, I will inform you, and then you may start at the topic. You understand?
Yes.
Excellent. I'll just give you an easy one. Here, this one. Okay? Alright, please turn it over. Alright, you have 1 minute and you may write whatever you like on. Your 1 minute start now.
So how long am I supposed to speak?
2 minutes. Alright, your 1 minute is up, then please start on your topic.
Okay, so... เดี๋ยวนะครับต้องบอกใช่ไหมเดี๋ยวนะครับผมต้องบอกว่าเนี่ยว่าอย่างนี
้ You don't have to tell the topic, you just go like, well, I'm going to tell you about...
Okay.
Or like, yeah.
So, I'm going to tell you about Tokyo.
Okay.
So, Tokyo is located in Japan, which is central Japan, actually. It is the capital. And I went to Tokyo for a vacation with my family. So, what is there to see in Tokyo that really impressed me was its cultural and technological advancements.
Right.
And what I liked about it is it's actually the same thing I mentioned, that their cultural and technological advancement is in another level.
Mm-hmm.
For example, when I was walking in the streets of Tokyo, I see the difference between Bangkok and Tokyo, which really surprised me.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I love the food there as well, which is a part of their culture.
Yeah.
Also, I get to see several advancements that are not cultural or technological advancement, but more of a moral advancement.
Okay. Not even close. ประมาณนาทีนึงอย่างนี้มังกรเดี๋ยวปัดไอ้หน้าจอเปิดนี่เป็นทางเลยพี่
เอ้ยไม่เป็นไรไม่เป็นไรเดี๋ยว
พ
ี่
ชายนะคืออย่างนี้มังกรไม่เป็นไรแบบทำเดี๋ยวพี่ชายคืออย่างนี้มังกรเราเริ่มดีแต่ว่า it's on another level เนี่ยคีย์นะครับคะแนนเนี่ยมันจะอยู่ที่ part 2กับ part 3เนาะแล้วประเด็นคืออย่างนี้เราใช้คำว่า advancement technological กับไอ้นั่น advancement มากเกินไปทีหลักเลยในที่นี้เนี่ยเราพูดเริ่มดีเริ่ม where it is นะครับ where when did you go there how was it like อธิบายให้ example หมายความว่ายังไงใช่ไหม
นี่ข้างบนเรียนดู
ใช่แต่ว่าเราต้องอย่างนี้เราต้องบอกว่า well one of the most เนี่ยเรา one of the most memorable place that I went before was Japan It has made a great impact in my life. And Tokyo is located in the heart of Japan, which is a capital city. Mm-hmm. And then I went there with my family as our vacation trip, and it was very enjoyable. Mm-hmm. And then when we went there, not only we went to Tokyo, but we also went to other provinces. But however, Tokyo made a great impression to me because of its technological and moral advancement. For example, in Japan, people are very well disciplined. They would line up, probably. They would respect public property. And most of all, they were very helpful, even though you're foreigners. However, being able to speak Japanese would help you more because they don't really understand English all that well. And of course, there were so many things to see. I went to Roppongi, which probably was the best place. It was tons of fun. And then we went there, and I bought a whole bunch of gadgets, and we went there to eat sushi within Roppongi, and it was sightseeing girls. And I gotta tell you, Japanese girls,
hot as hell.
Yes, they were not too polite. They were extremely beautiful. I mean, they were attractive. You can just look anywhere, you know, with their makeups, with their physique. With their outward appearance, it was all proper to me. And of course, as I'm a teenager, so that was probably the best memory I had.
So how old?
Yeah.
How old were you?
Yeah, but they can't ask. I went there when I was like 10, man. Then I'm helping you, understand? And then of course, if I have to tell you the most thing I like about Japan is probably not just the girl only, but the food. You know, because. They have the best sushi. I mean, this is the motherland of sushi we're talking about. So I went there and I killed half the ocean floor. I had tuna, salmon, I had sashimi, and then everything that you picked up from even from the market was fresh. So of course, you know, I had the best, you know, attainable sushi anyone could dream of. So that's probably the second best thing besides girls.
So they all look friendly,
just like you speak, but when you have to use good vocabulary, formal, just like you meeting a new friend at work. Okay? Yeah, we need to use all the time, right? Okay? Okay? Yeah, please try not to be a
mind.
Yeah. Alright. Please turn over your card. Okay, and those are the topics, and your 1 minute starts now.
Shit. Cool, quite well. Holy shit.
No, some topic. Oh, okay. Alright, your 1 minute. Thank you. Okay, your 1 minute is up, and please start on your talk.
So, I would like to talk about Tokyo.
Okay.
And Tokyo is located in central Japan, and it's a capital, actually. And when I went there, I went there for vacation with my parents.
Okay.
And it was pretty great trip.
Uh-huh.
So I would say that for me, it's one of the best cities I've ever visited.
Mm-hmm.
One of the reasons being, Tokyo is one of the best city for teenagers.
Okay.
And I really like teenage stuff.
Okay.
So when I went to Tokyo, two things surprised me. It was Harajuku.
Okay.
It was a hub for teenagers.
Okay.
When I was walking there, there's everything that teenagers like, such
yeah.
as fashions,
mm-hmm.
which I'm really interested in.
Okay.
And also, hot chicks.
Okay.
Another place I like is Shibuya.
Yeah.
This is, most people would say is the most touristy attraction. The most touristy attraction in Tokyo.
Mm-hmm.
So it was sprawling with life.
Great.
As I walked there, so many things I've never seen before, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Just like a diversity of people and
mm-hmm.
things I can learn.
Yeah.
So another place I went that other place don't have is probably Tokyo DisneySea.
Yeah.
I went to LA's Disneyland, but unlike LA's Disneyland, Tokyo's DisneySea is unique because it's only one in Japan.
Okay.
Well, I really liked that place. It was full of fun.
Okay.
And so when I came back to Tokyo after the visit of Tokyo Disneyland, I went to a rampage of food.
Okay.
The thing I like about it the most is probably about their cultural dishes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't like really the fusion kind of food. I really like the traditional ones.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So one of their best traditional foods are being in Shinjuku. Well, when every time I go there, I try to find something new to eat. And every time I go there, there's new things to eat.
Oh.
Unlike Bangkok, which is usually the same.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to eat it, but you're not eating.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Did you have it?
Yeah, but when you make a mistake, when you make a mistake,
you're
like, excuse me, whoa, I was going to say.
Oh, I see.
Okay,
all right, now you've got the structure. But nothing, you're not going to have to be less than 7 now, but try to focus more and deliver without mistakes. But if you do make a mistake, it's okay. Just like, oh, excuse me, I was going to say, by the way. Yeah, but if it's over two minutes, 10 seconds, hold it off. Thank you. That's enough.
Uh-huh.
All right. Now that was the end of part two. Okay. Then we're gonna move on to the third part. The third part, I will ask you something that is related to cities. Okay. You ready?
Yes.
Related to what?
It's like cities.
Okay.
All right. What are the main facilities in a large modern city?
Well, the main facility is probably about economical and business towers, skyscrapers, I say, in Bangkok.
Oh, great. So, how do you compare a modern city with a small town?
There is a great contrast between Bangkok and probably everywhere else in Thailand, which is probably like first world compared to the third world, which is underdeveloped.
Okay. เวลาเราพูดอย่างนี้เริ่มดีมากเลยแต่ต้องอธิบายตัวอย่างให้เห็นภาพออกมาเพราะว่าอะไรรู้ป่ะ Yeah, I mean between first world and developing countries. Try to use polite words. Don't use third world. Third world is, you know.
มันcriticizing นะ
Yeah. Like okay, we talk about something that under the law. Like for example, you can just look at the train infrastructure in Thailand. It's detrimental. It's horrible. Because if you go to Japan, they already have bullet trains. The worst train in Japan that they probably ride on is probably much better than what we have now.
Uh-huh.
In Thailand.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm. Okay. So, do you prefer to live in a large modern city and why?
Yes, I would prefer to live in such a large and modern metropolis.
Okay.
Because I'm still a teenager and still growing.
Yeah.
So I would like to see new and exciting things.
Yeah.
So, which means living in a city, I get to see more people
mm-hmm.
and see more girls.
Okay.
Also, I can keep up with all kinds of industries. Yeah.
All right.
วิธีที่เราจะ rephrase ตรงนั้นให้มันดู professional hard doing เหมือนกับ job interview นิดนึงนะเราก็ต้องบอกว่า
แสดงว่าทั้งหมดแต่ชิ้นต้อง formal
ไม่ต้อง formal ขนาดนั้น but talk intelligently hard doing you need to talk intelligentlyyou talk like, of course, it's preferable for me to live in a modern, large metropolitan because I can keep up with the latest trends, gadgets, and I prefer the urban lifestyle because it's more convenient. And of course, I get to meet girls more and, you know, have more interesting relationships. So probably that would be the best part of
the meeting.
Just enjoy แต่ไม่ต้อง overly คุณภาพเลยมั้ยนะครับพูดอย่างนี้พี่พูดอะพาร์ตตัวเอง
ถ้าสมมติเข้าไปแล้วพูดเหมือนโรบอทแต่ว่าพูดดีทุกอย่าง
you get 5.5 ก็ค่อยหักโรบอท you talk like a robot yeah เพราะฉะนั้น fluency สำคัญมากที่เรามีอยู่เนาะแต่เนี่ยยัง deliver fluency part 3ให้มัน formal กว่านี้นิดนึง alright so what are the advantages and disadvantages of living in a large city
Well, I say the advantages far outweigh the disadvantages, but for Bangkok it's different.
Okay.
So when you're in Bangkok, everything is hectic and chaotic.
Yes.
When you enter the city, you realize that the traffic jam is horrible.
Okay.
Well, which is hard for you to transport anywhere. But in contrast to that, the lifestyle is pretty straightforward and pretty technological.
I die there when I'm bored. Yeah, when it's stuck, it's stuck. We don't breathe.Breathe in, breathe out, calm. Okay. Okay. So, how stressful is life in a large city nowadays?
If we talk about Bangkok, the Bangkokers are not that stressed out because Thailand's mindset. Well, Thai people are usually generally relaxed, but unlike Bangkok, Tokyo is really, really different.
Okay.Explain why it's different. Why it's different from here.
Really different because Japanese expect each other to be disciplined, and they have to be on time. However, in Thailand, they just expect you to do your work.
วิธีพูดให้มันได้เกินเวลาเจอคำถามที่มันไกลขนาดนี้ใช่ป่ะ Make it into topic ที่ people can understand.เราก็บอกว่า when it comes to stress I don't think Bangkoker the Bangkokian when it comes to stress I don't think the Bangkokian would suffer that much because naturally Thai people have the sunny disposition of relaxation they have an understanding that the way of karma is pretty straightforward so they a little bit you know more comfortable when living something that is not stressful, even though in the urban sprawl life. However, on the contrary, life in Tokyo is much different because Japanese people are well disciplined and they are highly organized, so they feel quite stressful while being punctual and they have to be productive over 100% all the time. So I think that would be the drastic differences.
ใช่ป่ะคือผมคิดอย่างนั้นได้นะแต่แบบคิดไปพูดไปไม่ได้ไม่ต้องรีบไง
คือเป็นท็อปปิกก่อนหรือเป็นท็อปปิกพูดออกมาอธิบายแล้วก็คีย์เวิร์ดที่เราพูดเป็นท็อปปิกกลับมาใช้ต่อใช่ไหมคีย์เวิร์ดของพี่คือโอเค hectic busy life คีย์เวิร์ดใช่ป่ะ the differences ค่อยๆไล่ใจเย็นๆโอเค andHow do you think cities will change in the future?
Well, I think that the cities will continue to develop and advance really at a fast-paced rate. Just like Bangkok.
Okay.
When you look back 100 years ago, there's a major difference.
There were major differences.
And I say the same thing will happen in the next few hundred years.
Okay.
Who knows in a few decades, I say.
Okay.ทีนี้เวลาเราเจอโจทย์ speculation นะเมื่อก่อน they expect น้องต้องใช้นะครับน้องต้องสามารถใช้ future tense ได้น้องต้องใช้ adverb certainty ให้ได้น้องต้องใช้ future continuous ให้ได
้ว่า
น้องต้องมี clause this ทุกครั้งน้องจะเจอ speculation แล้วเมื่อกี้ดีที่มี past tense แต่น้องยังขาด future tense ขาดอะไรอย่างนี้อยู
่ there will be
เราวิธีที่เราจะ roll it out ใช่ไหมครับผมI definitely could see a tremendous changes
that will happen in Bangkok. Definitely about 2 decades from now, there will be great improvements on various fields when it comes to infrastructures and telecommunication in Bangkok. Probably people will be able to use many wireless devices for free in public places. And furthermore, the government will provide better health care for Thai people by that time. And why do you think that I'm quite optimistic about future changes in Bangkok? Because I believe that more people are getting education abroad. So if they broaden their horizon and learning something that is valuable abroad, they will bring those productivity back here and demand the government to implement those policies.
Yeah, government.
เข้าใจมั้ยแต่นี่คือสเปกูเลชั่น โอเคครับดีมากเดี๋ยวเราฝึกเพิ่มแต่เราเหนื่อยละมาเทคอะเบรกยุ่งเกิน
โอ้ยจะได้ไม่แบบ
ได้